Hello the beautiful people of Chewy Inspirations. Welcome back, yes, to another interesting, captivating, entertaining, and what? Juicy episode, yes. See, the thing is, we are going higher. We are upgrading and we are expanding, right? And this expansion is not something that comes in one particular sector or phase or country, as the case may be. This expansion, development, increment is all about countries in West Africa and Africa to the world. And you know my two favorites in West Africa that I always talk about, because oh my god, because when it comes to West Africa, you see these two countries, Ghana and Nigeria, got a space in my heart. For other West African countries, I'm so super sorry that most times I don't always talk about you all, but that aside, I would definitely advise that if you are a West African or an African, you just have something for me to talk about, kindly reach out to me and I will gladly expose and promote. But regardless, the motherland Ghana and Nigeria has stolen a space in my heart, right? I cannot stop, you know, showcasing, exposing and putting them out there with all they've got in the map of West Africa and Africa to the world, according to the title, you know by now. But today's topic definitely is going to take a different tone, a different pattern, which is all about exposing the ongoing projects in Ghana and in Nigeria that are already in completion or close to completion. Some have already commenced, some are already in the process of commencement, especially in my country, Nigeria. We're going to look at what these projects are all about, the importance of this project, how far this project has come in reality, and at the end of the day, we'll come back to do a conclusion at the end of the day. But before we delve into the projects going on in Nigeria, ordinarily, I will always come here to talk about Nigeria. Most times, it seems as though Abuja is the only state in Nigeria. No, but today we'll be taking it down to the city of Lagos, one of the biggest city that has always been put out on the spotlight in the map of Nigeria. Yes, Lagos City is one bubbling, lively city in the country Nigeria that has almost everything in place, yes, and in store. And it is one of the highest populated, congested city as we speak, that is seeking for expansion and also known as the city of Africa's largest economy, meaning that most of the economical growth and development we have in Nigeria majorly comes from the city of Lagos, Nigeria. So if you don't know Lagos, Nigeria, you are on a long thing. So in today's episode, we'll be looking at the first project, which is the Lekki International Airport, yes, that has been mapped out, and we'll look at the current state, what is happening there, the detailed information and all you need to know. Secondly, we'll be looking at, still in Lagos, the city of Lekki, Lekki Free Trade Zone. That is another massive project that is definitely, at the end of the day, going to break world records in the Western map of Africa. Yes, let's quickly take a look at these two projects, then come back again to look at what we have going on for the motherland Ghana.
Let's start by having a look at what exactly is a free trade zone. A free trade zone is a designated area where goods can be imported, stored, handled, manufactured, or configured and re-exported under specific custom regulation and generally not subject to custom duty. Free trade zones are generally organized around major seaports, international airports, and national frontier areas with many geographical advantages for trade. So what is Lekki Free Trade Zone? The Lekki Free Trade Zone is a major economic development project in Nigeria. It was established in 2006 by the Nigeria government and the Lagos state government. The zone is home to a number of manufacturing, logistic and service companies. The zone is also home to the Lekki deep sea port, which is the first deep sea port in Nigeria. The Lekki free trade zone is expected to play a major role in the economic development of Nigeria. So where is the Lekki free trade zone located and what is the land size? The Lekki free trade zone is a 16,500 hectare special economic zone located in the Lekki peninsula of Lagos state, Nigeria. The Lekki free trade zone is divided into four quadrants, each of which is managed by a different operator. The first quadrant is focused on manufacturing and logistics, while the second quadrant is focused mainly on information technology and telecommunication. And the third quadrant is focused on tourism and hospitality, while the last one, which is the fourth quadrant, is focused on research and development. Who is the owner of Lekki Free Trade Zone? The Lekki Free Trade Zone is owned by a joint venture between the Lagos State Government and a consortium of Chinese companies. The consortium is made up of China Africa Lekki Investment Investment Limited, which is the majority shareholder, the Lagos State Government, and Lekki Worldwide Investment Limited. The Lekki Free Trade Zone Development Company is the sole entity authorized by the Federal Government of Nigeria through the Nigeria Export Processing Zone Authority and the Lagos State Government to develop, operate, administer, and manage the southwest quadrant of the Lekki Free Trade Zone project. So which companies are already located within the Lekki Free Trade Zone? The Lekki Free Trade Zone has attracted a number of foreign investors. Some of the companies already within the Lekki Free Trade Zone are Coca-Cola, which has already built a bottling company within the zone. Samsung has built a manufacturing plant. So also is Siemens, who also have built a manufacturing plant, and GE, and also Honeywell. All the usual infrastructures, including roads, telecommunication, waste management, and a lot more, are already in place in the area. Some of the notable mega projects around the area are the Lekki Deep Sea Port, Dangote Refinery, and proposed Lekki International Airport, which is nearby. The Lekki Free Trade Zone is expected to play a major role in the economic development of Nigeria. The zone is expected to create jobs, attract foreign investment, and boost exports.
So a few other states in Nigeria have initiated or even built airports of their own. The proposed Lekki International Airport in Lagos State is generating more interest and commendation because of the nature of Lagos as a state. Recently, the Lagos State Government secured approval from the federal government to build an expansive airport that will be sitting on an estimated 3,500 hectares of land. The airport is to be developed in partnership with both local and foreign investors, and this airport is expected to cater to a minimum of 5 million passengers per year. In this video, we'll be sharing you some of the top facts about the new Lekki International Airport. The new Lekki International Airport will be situated along the Lekki-Egbe axis on the island section. So, this airport is going to serve the fast-growing industrial Lekki district. It's also going to serve the Lekki Deep Sea Port, the Dangote Refinery, the Lekki Free Trade Zone, and other locations around. This airport is adjacent to Alaro City, and the airport is going to be just 10 kilometers away from the Lekki Free Trade Zone. The new Lekki International Airport is to be constructed on 3,500 hectares of land, and this is supposed to cater for a minimum of 5 million people yearly, though there is a scope for future expansion. Upon completion, the Lekki-Egbe International Airport will complement the Murtala Mohammed International Airport Lagos, which has served over 5 million people. This new airport will not only complement Murtala Mohammed Airport, but also help to reduce congestion at the airport. The new Lekki International Airport is designed to accommodate the Airbus A380 and the world's largest passenger airline. This project is expected to take off in the year 2023. Master plans and aeronautical designs are in place already. However, studies are ongoing about the strategies, the funding, and other issues, after which the project will be taken to the marketplace. The Lekki-Egbe International Airport Lagos will be constructed in partnership with both local and foreign investors. And this airport will help to improve the economy of the state. Also, the airport will also help to provide various job opportunities for people around.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, without any further ado, before conclusions, let's head off to Ghana and see what Ghana has there in the structure and project of one of West Africa's largest mall in the motherland Ghana. And you know, one thing that is really interesting and fascinating about this project is going to beat the biggest, the largest in West Africa. That is definitely going to aid and facilitate so many opportunities, just like we have in Lagos, Nigeria. If actually completed, is definitely going to aid so many opportunities, which we are going to talk about at the later end of this video, right? So we are looking at Ghana's largest mall in the city of Accra, Ghana. And also, we'll be looking at Prempeh International Airport in the city of Kumasi. Yes, this is not in Accra, but in Kumasi. Everything, of course, cannot be in Accra. The most important thing is every city, every region having their own developmental structures, growth, and what have you. And at the end of the day, when we are done looking at these things, I will come back and give my 2 cents and give my input, right? So without any waste of time, let's look at this and we'll be right back.
Welcome to an exclusive preview of a game-changing project set to redefine shopping experiences in West Africa. Today, we invite you to witness the birth of something truly extraordinary, the Ghana International Mall. From its humble beginnings to its grand vision, join us as we journey through the construction progress and artist's impressions of this monumental endeavor. Get ready to be amazed as we unveil the future of retail excellence right here in the heart of West Africa. Welcome to the Ghana International Mall. At $250 million, the Ghana International Mall is poised to become West Africa's largest shopping center. This ambitious project is not just about bricks and mortar. It's about transforming the retail landscape of the entire region. Nestled strategically near Casa Global Villas and the Manet Police Station, its location speaks volumes about accessibility and prominence. Positioned at the crossroads of convenience and luxury, the Ghana International Mall promises to be more than just a shopping destination. It's a symbol of progress and prosperity for all of West Africa. Step into a world of unparalleled luxury and convenience at the Ghana International Mall. Spanning an impressive 100,000 square meters of commercial space, this colossal complex is set to redefine the retail experience in West Africa. But that's not all. With 150,000 square meters of residential flats, it offers a lifestyle like no other, seamlessly blending work, leisure, and living. But wait, there's more. Beyond shopping and living, and the Ghana International Mall boasts an array of recreational facilities designed to delight visitors of all ages. Take a refreshing dip in the sparkling swimming pool, let the little ones explore and play in the dedicated children's playground, or unwind in one of the other entertainment areas scattered throughout the mall. Here, every moment is an opportunity for relaxation and enjoyment. And when it comes to convenience, the Ghana International Mall has you covered. With ample parking space accommodating up to 5,000 cars, finding a spot is never a hassle. Whether you're stopping by for a quick shopping trip or planning to spend the day exploring everything the mall has to offer, rest assured that parking will be the least of your worries. Welcome to a world of luxury, leisure, and limitless possibilities at the Ghana International Mall. At the heart of the Ghana International Mall project lies a visionary mission to develop top-tier commercial lifestyle centers in Ghana that not only meet the needs of consumers, but exceed their expectations. With a commitment to excellence and innovation, the company behind the mall aims to create spaces that not only cater to shopping and entertainment, but also enhance the overall quality of life for residents and visitors alike. The Ghana International Mall isn't just another shopping destination. It's poised to become the epicenter of West Africa's commercial landscape. Situated strategically at the intersection of commerce and culture, the mall will serve as a beacon of progress and prosperity for the entire region. Its sheer magnitude and scope signify a new era of economic growth and development, signaling to the world that Ghana is open for business and ready to lead the way in the retail sector. But the significance of the Ghana International Mall extends beyond its physical presence. By aligning with Ghana's economic growth and urban development goals, the project is poised to catalyze positive change on a national scale. From job creation and increased revenue streams to enhanced infrastructure and urban renewal, the ripple effects of the mall's completion will be felt far and wide. As Ghana continues to position itself as a hub for investment and innovation, the Ghana International Mall stands as a testament to the country's boundless potential and limitless possibilities. The impact of the Ghana International Mall on Ghana cannot be overstated. One of the most significant contributions it will make is in the realm of employment. As one of the largest shopping centers in West Africa, the mall will create a plethora of job opportunities across various sectors, from retail and hospitality to maintenance and security. This influx of employment opportunities will not only provide individuals with steady incomes, but also contribute to increased income levels in the local community, thereby uplifting livelihoods and driving economic growth. Moreover, the Ghana International Mall will have a profound effect on retail revenue and the local economy. With its expansive commercial space and diverse array of offerings, the mall will attract a steady stream of shoppers from both near and far. This surge in consumer activity will lead to increased disposable income and heightened spending, injecting vitality into the local economy and bolstering retail revenue for businesses within and around the mall. This virtuous cycle of economic activity will create a ripple effect, fostering a thriving ecosystem of commerce and prosperity. Furthermore, the Ghana International Mall's significance extends beyond Ghana's borders. By positioning itself as a regional business hub, the mall will attract not only local shoppers, but also visitors from neighboring countries such as Cote d'Ivoire, Togo, and Burkina Faso. This influx of regional traffic will not only further boost retail revenue, but also solidify Ghana's reputation as a premier destination for commerce and trade in West Africa. As the mall flourishes, so too will its surrounding communities, creating a positive domino effect of growth and development across the region. In this way, the Ghana International Mall will not only elevate Ghana's status on the global stage, but also catalyze progress and prosperity throughout West Africa. As we come to the conclusion of our journey through the Ghana International Mall, it's clear that this project is more than just a shopping center. it's a catalyst for economic growth and urban development in Ghana and beyond. By providing employment opportunities, boosting retail revenue, and enhancing Ghana's status as a regional business hub, the mall is poised to reshape the economic landscape of West Africa for years to come. But our journey is far from over. We invite you to stay tuned for the grand unveiling of the completed mall, where you'll have the opportunity to experience the future of shopping in West Africa firsthand. From luxury brands to local favorites, the Ghana International Mall promises to offer something for everyone, creating a truly immersive and unforgettable shopping experience. To ensure you don't miss out on any updates or behind-the-scenes content, we encourage you to subscribe to our channel. By joining our community, you'll be the first to know about exclusive events, special promotions, and exciting developments at the mall. And finally, we invite you to share your excitement for the Ghana International Mall with your friends and family on social media. Whether it's through photos, videos, or simply spreading the word, your support plays a crucial role in making this project a success. Thank you for joining us on this incredible journey towards the unveiling of West Africa's epic shopping destination. Together, let's usher in a new era of prosperity and progress with the Ghana International Mall.
In today's video, we are going to take a look at the current updates on the Kumasi Airport City Development Project. We all know that the Kumasi International Airport has been open to the public, and then every international airport has an airport city like Kotoka International Airport. The Kumasi International Airport City has started already. Yes, the Kumasi International Airport, which is now Prempeh, the second international airport. The airport city in Kumasi has started already, and the demolition has started at the site. We all know that Kumasi Airport, or Prempeh, the second airport, is at a place where so many houses, so many buildings are already there. So they have to demolish substructures, including people's houses, before they can start the Kumasi Airport project. So currently, the demolition exercise has started. But before we move on to the airport city project, I just want you guys to check the newly commissioned Kumasi International Airport. Few months after commissioning, just check how it is going. Recently, this July, 1st July, it was open to the public, and this is how happy everybody was. These are the people traveling to their various destinations. Currently, there is no international flight yet, just the domestic ones. But very soon, international flight will start landing at the Kumasi International Airport, and everything is gonna be easy for the people of Kumasi whenever they are traveling from Kumasi to other countries. They don't have to come to Accra or people around Kumasi, Eastern Region, Bono Region, and the rest. They don't have to take another plane to Accra before they can take flight to their various destinations. They can fly right from the Kumasi International Airport, the Prempeh, the second international airport, to wherever they are going to. So guys, now let's get right into the video. Let's check out the Kumasi Airport City project, which is starting, which has started already.
So this is the site of the Kumasi Airport City project. So as you can see, the demolition has already started. People's houses and stores, anything that is closer to the airport city, the land they are going to use for the airport city, has been demolished. And one project has already started, that is the Kumasi Airport City. It is a luxury apartment which is named Kumasi Airport City. It has already started. Before this video ends, you are going to see a 3D video of the Kumasi Airport City project, the luxury apartment I'm talking about. This is how it is progressing. So this is the site of the Airport City project, and very soon it will be completed. Let's say some 2-3 years to come, it will be fully completed, and then the place will become a very beautiful place. The Kumasi Airport City promises to be one of the smartest cities in the whole of Africa and the world as a whole. So let's all anticipate and wait for this great initiative and great project, which is going to make Kumasi one of the cities in Africa everybody will wish to visit. Alright, so let's look at the 3D video of the Airport City project. So this building you are seeing right now is the Kumasi Airport City. So this project is named Kumasi Airport City. That is what is ongoing right now at the Kumasi Airport City project development. So as you can see, it's a very beautiful luxury apartment which is going to make the Airport City is going to change Kumasi and then Ghana as a whole, because it's going to be a smart city with everything being, as you can see on the screen right now, this is how it's going to look when it is completed. It is going to look exactly like this when it is completed. It's a very big project, a very, very huge mega project that is going to change the face of Kumasi Airport. So guys, let us all anticipate and wait for this mega project to be completed very soon in the city of Kumasi, where everybody will wish to visit and look at the project.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, just like you've rightly heard, for Lagos, Nigeria, what is going on there, I'll start by saying one thing about Nigerian projects is most times picturistic and video forms of projects, like putting out something out there for the world to see that is ongoing but hardly or barely comes to a completion. That is one bitter truth for sure. But I hope that from the current information I've gathered, that as this project has been commenced in this 2024 currently, that the support and everything whatsoever the Lagos State Government, in partnership with companies and industries here and there, would definitely come to a perfection and completion, because this is definitely going to serve a very good purpose in terms of development, in terms of employment, in terms of social interaction, connection, networking, in terms of, you know, real estate expansion. Now we can even see that we have so many companies ongoing there, even the refinery, even the deep sea ports and what have you. This project, at the end of the day, when completed, is definitely going to aid, support and promote not just the growth of Lagos, Nigeria, but West Africa as a whole. Because what is a fast rising and developing countries without structures, infrastructures, facilities, growth, development as such, right? And I believe that by the grace of God, time to time, I will come up here to update us on how far this project is going. And when this project in Nigeria finally comes to a completion, trust me to always put it out here for us to see, to congratulate, to appreciate and expose, as the case may be. So our fingers crossed, our hearts in prayers, hoping that for Nigeria, what is ongoing there, we come to a perfect completion and commissioning come 2024, 25, 26, as the case may be. Now, for that of Ghana, we can see that the largest mall we have in the city of Ghana is already almost in completion, almost just the finishing touching, the rounding up that is left for it to be commissioned as we speak in this August 2024. Hopefully before the end of this year, we still have few months to go, this project will be completed for the mall and commissioned respectfully and successfully. That is our aim, that is our goal. But of a truth, I will say this is massive, this is huge for the country Ghana. And even though it is individually owned in conjunction, in partnership with the state government and other companies, I will really say this would definitely do a great deal of development and what international relationship when it comes to what business wise and what have you for the motherland Ghana. So let's put our eyes looking forward to the completion and commissioning of this massive mall in the map of West Africa. And as well, the Prempeh International Airport in Kumasi is definitely, as we have heard, going to facilitate a lot of growth, development and progress in the land of Ghana, putting Ghana out and spotting them out on the spotlight right there in the map of Africa and Africa to the world. That is the aim, that is the goal. So time to time, I will come back again to rephrase back on the progress and the success of these projects that are ongoing in the motherland Ghana and in the country Nigeria. Yes, so that the world at the end of the day will know that we are thinking big, we are thinking outside the box, and we are working hard. And I just pray that even if it is not completed in this regime of the present leaders in Ghana, that leaders after leaders to come will follow suit, which I always trust the people of Ghana to always imbibe in, because one thing about them is continuing from where the next person stops in the positive way, right? It's one culture they have always practiced, they've held up high, and it's been a thing for them. So even if the projects that are already there are not completed, exception of what we've seen today, the leaders to come will definitely look at where the other people stopped and continue from there. And that's one good thing I want my country Nigeria to look at. Not just that, also maintenance culture. When you put up structures, when you put up facilities, progress like this, development like this, follow up and constantly you know, maintain them so that it will stand the test of time and serve its cause and purpose. Not just, you know, saying and not completing, not doing, leaving it halfway, it's not a good culture. And secondly, having it and not maintaining it is not a good culture. So, ladies and gentlemen, I will say, with this, we can see clearly and attest to the fact that the country Ghana and Nigeria, at least in West Africa, are trying their best to put themselves out in the spotlight, despite their challenges, despite their shortcomings, and despite their struggles. And that's why we will not stop talking, we will not stop exposing, we will not stop, you know, pushing out these things, so that our leaders will know that we have an eye on them. What they have promised, they will fulfill. They will know that people are definitely ready to hold them accountable with their promises, not just coming to promise, not just coming to say, and at the end of the day, nothing will be showed up for. This time around, by the grace of God, God on their side, we are praying and encouraging them, right, to try their best to always, when they come into position, complete this project and bring it to a completion and make us happy, make us proud as citizens. And not just that as well, look at the common needs of the people, the challenges of the people, the basic needs of the people, not just project alone, because the growth of a country, the success of a country in this 21st century does not fully rest on infrastructures, building and what have you, but also in catering for the basic needs of the common citizen in form of employment, just like these projects will definitely bring, in form of employment, growth and development, right? Down to the common masses, down to the citizen, so that at the end of the day, everybody will be happy. Sorry, I had to take this long to talk about it, because it is something that we are definitely looking out for. Put an eye on this space for the completion and commissioning of these projects, as long as life is willing and God willing. Okay, and with this, I will say we've come to the end of this episode. What are your thoughts? What are your opinion? What do you think about the project going on in Nigeria that we have already heard about, and that of Ghana? What do you think? Let us know in the comment section, respectfully, please. Let's be guided respectfully. We are not here to compare and contrast. We are here to expose, we are here to project, and we are here to encourage, right? And support ourselves as citizens of different countries, promoting West Africa and Africa to the world. That's the aim and that's the goal. So leave your thoughts, your opinions, constructive criticisms, or what have you, corrections, right there in the comment section, and I will gladly respond. One thing you people should applaud me for is that I take my time to read your comments and respond accordingly. I don't just give it a love, I read your comments. So when you leave me a comment, be rest assured that I will read and respond. That's to show how much you guys mean to me, how much your input, your opinion means to me, and how much I love you at the end of the day. I want to encourage you to keep interacting in the comment section, interacting by hitting the like button. And if this is your first time as well hearing my voice, I am Chivik Inspirations. And here in Chivik Inspirations, we say it just the way it is. We say things that are going on in West Africa, in the motherland Ghana, Nigeria, exposing them to the limelight, on the spotlight, so that the world will know just the way it is. So if it is bad, it is bad. If it is good, it is good. We don't mix words, and we encourage growth and support and progress, right? Not to demote, not to demean, demarket any individual, any country, but to promote, expose these countries, individuals in West Africa and Africa to the world. And as well, entertain, educate, inspire, and motivate us in a nutshell. So you can get it as a dull moment right here on Chivik Inspiration. So what are you waiting for? Think no further for hitting on that like button. Kindly hit on that subscribe button. It's actually free of charge. Yes. Remember as well to always keep it real, safe, happy, and blessed out there. Till I come up here in my next episode. But for now, this is me, Chivik Inspiration, saying do have a lovely, successful, a pleasant, and a blissful day. See you in the comment section. Bye, guys.